Ishgard cannot well endure another assault. Even should her knights succeed in turning back the Horde, the casualties will be catastrophic.
But what other choice do we have? It's not like we can talk it over with them. Dragons and men aren't exactly on speaking terms.
With certain notable exceptions.
You don't mean Iceheart?
When last you spoke with her, she lamented her crimes, did she not? Then there remains a sliver of hope. If we can persuade Iceheart to act as our intermediary, we may yet be able to convince Nidhogg to abandon his bloody course.
If there is to be a meeting, I would accompany you.
Estinian.
Even with your intermediary, Nidhogg's blood rage may render him deaf to reason. However, the mere attempt may afford our forces precious time to prepare. Of course, you might also consider a more direct approach to ending this conflict. With the power of the Eye at my disposal, and the vaunted strength of the Warrior of Light, we could conceivably slay the beast outright.
If we are to risk a face-to-face meeting with the Dread Worm, I for one would feel safer in the company of the Azure Dragoon. However, I should only turn to your lance if my words failed to find their mark. Is that clear?
Perfectly. I shall assume that Iceheart enjoys similar diplomatic protection until instructed otherwise. A word of advice. Think carefully before divulging the particulars of this plan to Sir Emeric. 'Twould not do to have the Lord Commander accused of consorting with heretics.
Indeed. I thank you for your counsel, Estinian. We shall be honored to have you with us.
I am glad to be of service.
I want the defenses of the outer ward rechecked. See to it that the ballistas are in good repair and supplied with enough ammunition for a prolonged siege.
At once, my lord.
Ah, 'twould seem I have visitors. And unlike those massing beyond our walls, these ones are welcome.
Pray forgive us for interrupting you in the midst of your preparations, Sir Emmerich, but our suit concerns the impending assault. To speak plain, we believe there is a chance the invasion might be halted before it even begins. I can divulge little more at this time, but I must nevertheless request that you advise the Holy See to refrain from launching any preemptive sorties whilst we seek to put our plans in motion.
I will gladly lend my support to any endeavor that could spare the blood of my countrymen, but I would know more of the cause you would have me champion. Will you not share aught of this mysterious undertaking?
Know that I have offered my lance to aid in this endeavor. I cannot claim that its success is assured, but our actions should serve to delay Nidhogg's advance at the very least. Which is more than can be said for the ill-conceived counterattack advocated by the Sea's more vocal crusaders. They offer glorious death, but little hope of victory.
Aye, their proposal does not inspire confidence. Our resources should rightly be spent shoring up the city's defenses. The Azure Dragoon and the Warrior of Light sallying forth together to face the Dreadworm Nidhogg. I must admit, the mere thought of it does much to dispel my misgivings. Go then, carry out your plan. I shall do what I can for you within the Holy See.
such commotion?
Yes, Your Eminence. The bells of the observatorium warn of our enemy's approach.
So, the dragons are coming. Let them come, in their hundreds and their thousands. With the divine blade in our hands, we shall rend their flesh and drown the heretics in their master's blood. Even Nidhogg and his foul brood shall be powerless to resist us. And when we have rid the world of their pestilence, we shall turn our attention to our Ascian allies. See that they are suitably rewarded for their invaluable assistance.
If I may, Your Eminence, the Paragons wield powers strange and unknowable. Can we be certain that they will not see through our deception?
We can be certain of naught save the righteousness of our cause. If you would be a true leader of men, you must possess conviction as well as caution. We seek to excise the root of an evil that has blighted us for 1,000 years. The risk is worth the reward.
And what of Estinian and this Warrior of Light? They have plans of their own.
Leave them to their purpose. We must each play the role we have been given. You and your chosen brothers, most of all.
For the glory of King Thordon.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.